This conference will now be recorded.
So here it talks about what is a service. So service is a means of delivering value to the customer by facilitating outcomes customer want to achieve without the ownership of the specific cost or risk. You go to the hotel and you stay there without the worry of how the electricity is provided, how the water supply is provided. So cost and risk are transferred to the service provider, that is the hotel, and customer focus on the outcomes versus needs. Okay. Yeah. The customer or the people who transfer the cost and risk to the service provider and retain focus on the outcomes. Whereas service provider takes on the cost and risk and responsible for the means of achieving questions. Any achieving outcomes. Any questions here?
No.
So what is service management? The company manages the people, the skill set to deliver the service. So if I go from the bottom to up, so company has resources and capability that form and collectively known as service asset. And these service asset perform the work and give the services to the customer. And when the customer gets the benefit, it is the value that they are getting it and hence reach the business outcomes. So this is how the service management works. Any questions here?
No. Good.
So resources are here, like for example, financial capital, infrastructure, applications and information, whereas capability is management, organization, process, knowledge, etc. Okay.
And resources are financial, infrastructure, application, information.
Yeah. Any another thing you want to say in this slide?
No, I'm just trying to make a comparison with what I'm doing usually.
Yeah, please go ahead.
And people are not part of resources.
People are part of resources as well and capability as well. That's what it is saying here. Okay, because they are resource as well, and when we increase the skill set, the people get skilled enough. Okay, so they are part of both.
Okay, they are part of both. Okay. Okay.
So now it is saying that why it is a need of a SM. Because technology is advancing day to day. Competition is rising. Development is like at peak. Okay. So that's the reason every organization is a service organization where we cater service through the group of people. And almost all the service today are IT enabled. So service management is defined as a set of specialized organizational capability for enabling value to the culture in the form of service.
Mm-hmm.
Any questions here?
Yeah, what is SM mean? SM.
What is service management? SM stands for service management.
Okay.
Any other question?
No.
Yeah. So the purpose of ITL V4 is to provide the organization with a comprehensive guidance for the management of IT-enabled service in the digital economy. So it gives you a framework. It is designed to ensure that an effective, efficient, flexible, coordinated, and integrated system for the governance and the management of IT services is established and continually improving in the organization. Any questions?
That's the purpose only of the ITIL Foundation, huh? Or
yes.
Okay.
Nobody would come to audit you if you don't follow it. But yes, it is giving you a framework and you will realize that it's very good. Just imagine that you are an entrepreneur of the company.
Mm-hmm.
And think of that you are the CEO of the company or the entrepreneur or the owner of the company, then you will realize that you need a framework. So ITS service value system facilitate integration and coordination of the organizational components and activities and provide a strong, unified, value-focused direction for the organization. So when the opportunity or demand for a service comes in, as per ITS, we follow a service value chain that we will be going to learn in the later slide, and we generate value to the customer. Or we give value to the customer. Okay.
Okay.
So we'll talk more about this service value chain diagram in the later slide. Okay.
Okay.
Key concept of service management that is coming later on in the later slide. Let's pull up. So by the end of this module, you will be able to describe the relationship between the value and its stakeholder, including the organization, service providers and service consumers and other stakeholders. Recall the definitions of the service consumer roles of a customer, user and sponsor. We will also describe the key concept of the value co-creation through the service relationship, including the service relationship management, service provision and service consumption. We will also talk about, describe the relationship between the product, service offering and the services. Describe the key concept of value creation with the services, including outcome, output, cost, risk, utility and warranty. We will talk about what do you mean by utility and warranty, what's the difference between them, and recall the definitions of them. So this is all that we will be talking about in the next few slides. Now, this is the definition of value. What do you mean by value? So if you see in the bubble, value is the perceived benefits, usefulness and importance of something. Like for example, this ITL training. You want promotions in your company, and if this ITL certification helps you in getting your promotions, then this ITL training would be of great value. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
So that's what it's written in the start, that service management is defined as a set of specialized organization capability for enabling value to the customer in the form of service. So developing the specialized organization capability mentioned in the above definition requires the understanding of the nature of value, that what customer is looking for. Okay. The nature and scope of the stakeholder involved, how value creation is enabled through the service. Any questions on this page?
No, just check. It's clear. Yes, no, it's clear. Yes. The example you took with my objective.
Yes, I took the real time scenario.
Yeah.
Because the more you relate practically, it's better for you. Okay.
Yes.
So now, this slide is saying organization facilitate value creation, and in the bubble it is written as an organization is a person or group of people that has its own functions with responsibility, authorities and relationship to achieve its objectives. Okay, so organization vary in size and complexity, like Apple, Samsung, Dell, they are different in organization, and in their relation to the legal entity, from a single person to team to complex network of individuals, legal entities united by some common objectives, relationships and authorities. So every organization is different. Okay. That's what it is saying here. And the organization's responsibility is to make people grow up to facilitate this value. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Any another question on this page?
No.
So how value is created then? So they are saying, if you understand this diagram, so this view treated the relationship between the service provider and the service consumer as monodirectional and distant. Okay, service provider gives a service to the consumer. So how the value is created?
Okay.
Any other question on this page?
No.
Let's go ahead.
Yes, I understand that the value the service is monodirectional.
Yes. Okay.
So we have to deliver something to other people.
Correct.
Okay. Good.
So here they're saying provider and consumer co-create the value. That means more and more the organization recognize that the value is co-created through an active collaboration between the provider and consumer, as well as other organizations that are part of the relevant service and relationship. That means there can be some vendors, suppliers as well, who can help the service provider to deliver the service. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And they continuously give the feedback to the service provider to improve it. That's why they are saying provider and consumer co-create the value.
Okay.
Let's check the page. Any questions?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The vendor are providing a feedback to the service delivery to improve the service or the value.
Yeah. Anything else?
Okay. No, thank you.
So there are some service consumer roles like customer who defines the requirement for the services and takes the responsibility for the outcomes from the service consumption. They are users who a person who uses the service. Sponsor is the person who authorizes the budget for the service consumption or who funds the resources. Any question on these definitions?
Okay, I would like to know the requirement are defined by the service delivery or by the consumer?
I beg your pardon?
The requirement. I saw here in the first paragraph, a person, the consumer is a person who defines requirement.
Mm.
I thought that the consumer is the person who receives this. This service or
yes
okay, who is defining the requirement?
You will be defining the requirement. You said for ITL training. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Any other question?
Okay, it's clear now.
Let's go ahead. Yeah. Other stakeholder in value. They can be shareholder like the diagram. They can be employees. They can be community like in social groups we have right now in today's world. So these are the other stakeholder who hold some value in the project, for example, or the service.
Okay.
Just check the page. Let's see it.
Uh-huh.
Now, service and product. This is the definition coming here. What do you mean by service? So, service is a mean of enabling value for creation by facilitating the outcomes that the customer want to achieve, like ITL training that I'm giving to you. Without the customer having to manage specific cost and risk, you're not bothered about internal details right now. Okay. Mm-hmm. And your service is that we are giving you a training of ITL. So the service an organization provides are managed on one or more of its products. Whereas a product is a configuration of resources created by the organization that will be potentially valuable for their customers.
Okay.
Like a laptop, like a phone. Okay, so products are typically complex and are not fully visible to the consumer. The portion of a product that the consumer actually sees does not always represent all of the components that compromise the product and support its delivery. Organization define which product components their consumers see and tailor them to suit their target consumer groups. any question on this page.
No, it's good. No, I understand the difference between product and value.
Good. So what is service offering? It like Multisoft is offering many services, many trainings. Okay. So a service offering is a description of one or more services designed to address the needs of our target consumer group. A service offering may include goods, access to resource, service actions. So goods can be like a tangible items, okay? Access to resource like the e-learning website, and the service action is the training that is done right now.
Okay.
So I would like you to just read this page. If any question, then ask me. And every, I will just say that in every slide, I'm just asking any question. It is not being sarcastic. It is just that I'm able to download what is needed. If something goes wrong or something you need an explanation again, that's why I'm asking you any questions. Okay. So that's the reason I'm asking you at the end of every slide. Okay.
Yeah. Understand. Uh-huh. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, can move on.
So what are service relationships? So service provisioning consists of activities performed by a service provider to provide a services. So there is a service relationship management. In normal language, we say business relationship management. That consists of joint activities performed by a service provider and a service consumer to ensure continual value co-creation based on the agreed and available service offering. So there is a coordinator that is coordinating to you how about the training, about the exam. So this is what they are trying to say. Whereas service consumption consists of activities performed by a service consumer to consume the service, like today and the Saturday that we will be having the training. Okay.
Yeah.
Just check the page.
Uh-huh.
So a service provisioning follows thus following the below pointers. Management of providers sources configured to deliver the service, provision of access to the resources for the user, fulfillment of the agreed service action, and service performance management and continual improvement. Like you are given the access of the training portal, e-learning website, the sample papers will be given to you, the exam will be coordinated, it will be booked for you, and finally in the end, a feedback will be taken so that we can check that are you happy with the service and all those stuff, and would move on with the continual improvement. That's what it is saying.
Okay.
Now just check the pitch. Any question?
No. No question.
Now, this is a very good slide of service relationship model. That means service provider are also service consumers. We can be a vendor to another organization. Okay. That's why they are saying that the service provider can be a service consumer as well. Okay.
Okay. So between organizations, there are also relation.
Yes, they can be vendors in your organization.
Can be vendor to okay.
Yeah, you're correct. So they can be in this diagram. There are four organizations. They have some relationship between the organization, and they are the service consumers as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Now there are three terms: value, outcome, cost, and risk. Value is the benefit that you realize. Okay. outcome is the result of the service. Cost, obviously, the money, and the risk is any uncertainty that you trigger from the service, okay, or you think of that this risk can trigger off. So a service is a mean of enabling value co-creation by facilitating outcomes that the customer want to achieve without the customer having to manage the specific cost and risk. You go to the hotel, you're not bothered about the electricity, water, AC and all those stuff, okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's what it is saying. Now just check the page.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, let's go ahead.
Yeah.
Now, risk is any uncertainty that can trigger off in the project. COVID is identified as a risk. That's why people are working from home right now. Okay. So, in every project, any service provider understand the risk that can trigger off. Okay. And develop their own action plans, mitigation plans, contingency plans to handle that particular risk.
Yeah.
Now just check the page.
Okay.
Now here comes a good slide of utility and warranty. It's good for exam point of view as well. I will like you to just read this page and then I will discuss. Okay.
I finished. Hello.
So, what do you understand by utility and warranty now? Can I ask you?
Please come again.
I'm saying that what do you understand by this slide now?
Yes, what I understand, the utility is the something we offer, like a product or service to meet
Correct.
Agreement. And the warranty is to ensure that the product will meet agreement, will meet the requirement of what we agreed before.
Yes, so utility means what is the need of the hour? Is it providing that need? That service is giving me that need, okay? Or provide fulfilling that need. That is fit for purpose, okay? Mm-hmm. Just remember the word fit for purpose. Utility means fit for purpose, okay?
Yeah.
Whereas warranty means that it is fit for you. That means it's available when I need it. It's capable enough. The security is there. And the continuous is there. Suppose a broadband connection is there. It's not it's a dropping connection. So it's not a great warranty.
Okay.
So just remember, utility is good for exam as well. The utility means fit for purpose. Warranty means fit for use. Okay.
Oh, okay.
We find this question coming up in the exam. So please remember.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Let's go ahead. Mm-hmm. Now we will be going to talk about key concept of ITIL. Now these are the four dimensions of ITIL. The first one is the organization and people. The second is information and technology. The third is the processes and value streams. Sorry, the third is partners and suppliers. There is no order to it, so don't worry about it. And the fourth is value stream and processes. Okay, and there are some environmental, economical, and technological factors that affect the service. Like COVID is the best example. Okay, if I talk about the environmental factors.
Okay.
So slowly and slowly, in the next few slides, we will be discussing.
So I have a question. Those factors they can be a risk for providing some service management.
Yeah.
Your environment factors.
Yes.
So political factors, economic factors.
Factors behave like a constraint to us. Okay.
The constraint. Yes.
Any other question?
No.
Okay, let me ask you, do you want to stop here and continue in the next class if it is too much, or do you want me to continue? What's your thought?
Yeah, we can continue and we see.
Okay, so 84 slides are there. We will do half of it. Okay, that means 42, 12, 11 slide more, or wherever you think of that it is too much for you. The maximum is 42 slide, because I don't want to 42. Run.
Okay. Okay, let's go to 42. Yes, 42. Okay.
And just in case you want to stop before, let me know.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, organization and people, the first one, that means we should have a formal organization structure, the culture, roles and responsibility, required staffing and competency among this first dimension. Okay. Any question here?
No. It's clear.
Now, by the term people, they mean updating the skills and competency, management and leadership styles, communication and collaboration, broad knowledge for plus deep specialization, common objective, facilitate value co-creation, and break down silos. Silos are the gaps between the departments or between the groups. Okay.
What is this? The silos, please.
Silos is like a gap. Okay.
Yeah. So okay.
So breakdown of silos should be there. Okay. There should be no gaps between the communication.
Okay. Okay.
The second dimension is information and technology. That means I should be well versed with the information, knowledge, the technology running in the company to provide the service, and the sound relationship between the components. Okay.
Okay.
So, for many services, information management is the primary means of enabling the customer value. Like the broadband should be available, reliable, accessible, timeliness is there, accuracy is there, and relevance is there. And if there is any challenges, so we have to see where the issue is coming on. Okay. So the challenges which come is obviously the security. Nobody can should hack it, for example, and all those stuff. Okay.
From security, for yes, the security of system, eh?
Correct.
Okay.
Any other question here?
No, thank you.
The third dimension is partners and suppliers. These are the people who are like the third party, who gives you the third party services like internet, the workstations, might be the building is on the lease. Okay. So service partnerships are there who share the common goals and risks. And you collaborate with the suppliers to achieve the desired outcomes. Okay. So there are formal contracts, in which the separation policy is also written there. And every organization and every service depends to some extent on service provided by the other organizations. Any questions here?
No.
So, the fourth dimension is value streams and processes. Processes are the set of activities like HR process, recruitment process, sales process, which define the activity flows, control, and procedures needed to achieve agreed objective. So, these are the activities that the organization undertakes to fulfill the service of the organization. So, we have to see how activities are organized, how value creation is done, so that it ensures that the stakeholders are happy, okay, they are well content, and they are efficiently and effectively managing the service.
Okay.
Any questions here?
No. It's clear.
So, this comes a definition of process. A process is an interrelated or interacting activity, like an HR process, for example, that transforms input to output. So it is said that at least one input is there and at least one output is generated at the end of the activity. This is a common jargon. Okay. So we believe that a well-defined process can improve productivity within the organizer or within an access organization. Any questions here?
No.
Now just spend 2 minutes here and then we will talk about
it. Okay.
Any question here from this slide now?
Okay.
Make sense?
Yeah, no. Yes, it's good.
Would you like to say something here?
So this is the value stream.
So I could not hear that, sorry.
Yeah, this I'm asking you, this is the value stream.
Yes. Stream is a river, right? So how this river flows in, okay, that's what it is saying.
Okay.
Let's go ahead.
Yeah.
Now this is a very common mnemonic, PESTL, okay. Now what it is, every service or service provider faces this PESTL. There can be lots of factors that constrain or influence the service provider operation. So in short, it is known as PESTL. That means P stands for political, E for economical, S for social, or T as in technological, L as in legal, and E as in environmental. So just remember, for example, in TPO, it is very good slide.
Yeah, it's I understand.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The exam consists of objective questions. Okay, it's not theoretical. Okay, multi-choice questions, and you will get the sample papers in the e-learning website. Just practice it. It's a good one.
Okay.
Any another question here?
No.
Okay. So the service value system here we are going to talk about. So what is service value system? First, I will read the definition in the bubble. So ITL service value system describes how all the components and activities of the organization work together as a service to enable the value co-creation. Okay. So these components and activities together with the organization resources can be configured and reconfigured in the multiple combinations in the flexible way as circumstances change. But this is required. But this requires the integration and coordination of the activities, practices, teams, authorities, and responsibility, and all parties to be truly effective. So all of them go together, combine to form service value system. Any question here?
No, it's clear.
Okay. And so we have done. Sorry.
There's, yes, I understand that there is nothing static.
Yes, it is not. Because IT is dynamic, right?
Dynamic, yes.
Okay. IT is dynamic, the requirements keep on changing, so it is not static. Very good point.
Yeah. Okay.
Now we will stop here. I will expect you to revise it. Okay?
Yes, I will revise.
And we will. I'm just stopping the recording because now it's no longer that we should record.
Okay. How can I?